Is it live?
Hello?
Is it live? I don't know. Hopefully it's live.
It says it in the corner.
What?
It says live in the corner, so I'm sure it is.
Oh, yeah. It does say live. I cannot. So many technical difficulties is made. We have zero viewers anyway, so it doesn't matter what we say right now.
Oh, my gosh. My other computer almost just fell off this keyboard, and I just died.
We don't need more accidents today, Maureen.
It took us an hour to get this going.
No, it took more than an hour. I started at 6:30. It's been an hour and a half of difficulties. Oh, hello, 27 people.
Hello.
Welcome. If you want to ask us any questions, head on over to Twitter, because I don't know if the Q&A thing is working right now. So go on over to Twitter and do hashtag ostentatious, which you'll know how to spell ostentatious because it's on the live stream here, and just ask questions about Pride and Prejudice or Jane Austen. Bless you. Or say bless you to Natasha. Whatever you want to talk about, let's talk about it, because it's been an hour and a half of stressful things. So it'd be nice to be happy right now. You know? Okay.
All right.
We should talk about the book that we're here to talk about. Did you
mine downstairs? I did read it.
Maureen.
I left mine downstairs. I wasn't even here when you guys said we were holding it up.
Oh,
so.
Well, I'll get another one for you.
Oh, I haven't read
any.
This
Which
is
one
my favorite edition. I like this edition the best. It's the most prettiest.
Ooh, that's a really pretty edition.
Are you serious? Ooh, I like that. Are you serious, Natasha? Look at this one. This one's the best. It has.
Doesn't that one have like all the books in it?
No, that's this one.
Oh my gosh.
That's this one. Ow!
I saw that one at Powell's.
What?
I saw that one at Powell's. I wanted to bring it home.
Oh, yeah. I got this one at Barnes & Noble. It's like $7 at Barnes & Noble.
What?
Yeah! And it has like the fake gold leaf, but it's kind of rubbed off a little bit. But, and also, it's very tiny font. So, it's really nice to look pretty on your bookshelves, but I don't know if I would read from it. But this one, it's worth it. I read from this one this time, and it was like a children's book.
I really want to go get mine, because mine is really pretty, and I love it.
Go get it!
I'll run and get it. I'll go get my charger, too, just in case.
That would just be the cherry on top of the technical difficulty if Maureen's computer died.
Okay, well, I realized that the ostentatious hashtag has been used before, so maybe
it has.
Yeah, there's like other things on in the hashtag.
I thought I was original, but I guess not.
But, I mean, the tweets are still showing up, so that's fine.
Okay.
No one's really.
I'll look it up. I have not checked the thing.
Okay. So thank you everyone for coming.
Group named Ostentatious. That's so cool.
It's like a club or something.
Yeah, it's, wow, they do like Jane Austen, they do the improvised Jane Austen novel in London. We have to go to London and we'll go see them.
I want to do that. And there's also like those festivals that you can go to. Didn't we talk about this one time?
No.
Like Bath? Yeah, there's like festival. Oh no, I talked about somebody else. There's festivals you can go to and dress up as like Austen. It's basically the movie.
Austenland, right?
Basically like Austenland.
Yeah, because Jane Austen lived in Bath.
Yeah.
And when we went to Bath, we like went to some of the places where she was. There and the what's it called? It's in Northanger Abbey, I think. The pump room, that's where like a lot of balls and stuff were in Northanger Abbey, which we're going to read in October. And that's like an actual place is the pump room. And we went there and it was
that's so cool.
Pretty. That's so cool.
Here's my book.
Oh, it is pretty. Ooh. It looks
it's
like
it's part of a set. So all of them match. It's all Jane Austen books and it's in a big box.
Ooh. And didn't it has that for you?
What? No, I got it for me. I got one for Katie, and then I also got one for me because it was $30 for a huge box set.
Yeah.
But it has a bookmark and yellowed pages, but it also has illustrations. So, like, that's one.
Oh.
And they're super pretty. The box set usually goes on sale at Christmas, just so you know.
Thank you.
It's called the Heirloom Jane Eyre box set.
Also, it has Jane Eyre, too.
Or, sorry, Jane Austen. Why am I saying that? But it has, like, all of her books.
Okay.
So, and they're all, and it's just really pretty. You can look it up. It's beautiful.
That's the good thing about this book club is that you can either spend no money because you can find them for free, or you can spend a whole bunch of money and buy all of the pretty versions.
Other pro tip is that I went online, like, a couple weeks ago because I was going somewhere, and so I was like, I'll just get it for free on my Kindle because you can get it for free on anything. I was like, I'll just get it for free, and then I will, like, read it on my Kindle while I'm doing this other thing. So I went and got it for free, and then it was like, do you want to purchase the WhisperSync audiobook edition for $1.99? And I was like, yeah, I do.
Did that happen to you too?
No, I went on Audible to look for it, and they had it for $1.95.
I don't have Audible, so I was like, give it to me.
Okay, it's WhisperSync, so it's I always miss the deals. Oh, okay. We have a question.
Oh.
Best book for a first-time reader of Jane Austen. I say Pride and Prejudice.
Yeah.
I think Pride and Prejudice is a good one. I think Sense and Sensibility is probably the second best one that you could read. Pride and Prejudice, just everybody knows, but
yeah.
I've tried to read Emma. I mean, I'm sure I'll read it with this book club, but I've tried to read Emma and haven't gotten through it yet, but I love Sense and Sensibility. It's my favorite Jane Austen book, so I'm just like,
November recommend. Book is Emma. Yeah, it's November's. I like Emma. I really like that one. It's a really divisive book because some people either love it and they love Emma or they hate it.
I love the movie and I love the character, but I couldn't get into the book at first. But Sense and Sensibility will always be my bae.
Yeah,
I like Sense and Sensibility. It's just because it has that, like, my favorite trope of all time. That, like, anytime it's in a book, I'm like, this book is my favorite book ever.
Which one? Yeah.
Oh, best friends to lovers. That trope where it's like best friends fall in love.
I love
that's my, like, anything that has that in it. I'm like, all right, I'm in. I'm 100% here for it.
I love that trope, too. It's just, like, it's so much sweeter.
I like it when, like, I like Mr. Darcy when, like, he's so, so rude to her.
You like the jerks to lovers?
Yes, I like that.
I have to say, I feel like from the book, like, he's not as terrible of a person in the book because, like, in the movie, all you get is, like, just, like, him shutting everything down and then, like, he does all this stuff and you're like, where the crap is this coming from?
That's my favorite part when he, like,
there's the hand thing.
When he touches the hand, then he, like, clenches it. Oh, I love it.
So, beyond the hand, like, actual him talking about stuff, he don't, like, doesn't say anything, but, like, in the book, you kind of get those moments in his head and then you also get to see him, like, actually changing his character. Like, in the movie, all you see is, like, what he does because of it, but, like, in the book, you see he's, like, changing his character and his countenance because she called him out and he was like, oh crap, you right, girl, instead of just being like, I love you, so I'm gonna do all these things for you, which is also good, but, like, actually being like, oh, I really do need to change myself is even better.
Like,
what are some of your, like, general thoughts about the book?
I love it.
Definitely this time, I sympathize more with Mary and with Lydia. I think because I rewatched Lizzie Bennett Diaries 2, and it shows just how, like, much of a jerk George Wickham is, and how he really, like, took advantage of the young girls. And also that Mary, like, she just felt overlooked, so she tried really hard to be good at things, but she's just annoying, but...
yeah.
Like, it made me hate George a lot more, but then, like, everybody else more.
Yeah.
Sorry, keep going.
No, you go ahead. It's your turn since I asked the question.
I feel like Mr. Collins in the movie is a lot more annoying than Mr. Collins in the book. Because, I mean, he is super annoying in the book, but, like, in the movie, it's just, like, a whole other level. But with, Charlotte, I didn't, like, sympathize with her more, but I was less of, like, you an idiot, girl, and more of, like, okay, like, that's a smart decision for your future.
I, Oh, yeah. I guess I think Charlotte, I think I sympathized her more in the movie than in the book, because you didn't really, you saw her actions and you got, like, in her mind in the book. And the movie was just like, oh, okay, cool, whatever. I Mrs. Why am I going print? What's her last name?
Bennett?
Bennett, Mrs. Bennett, thank you. Mrs. Bennett is way more annoying in the book than she is in the movie. Like, the things that she says, and if I were to play someone in, like, the production or a movie, I would choose Mrs. Bennett because she's so annoying.
She's so overly dramatic, and at one moment, she's like, oh, I'm going to die, like, I'm dying because of the disgrace, and then once it goes her way, she's like, I'm fine now, like, everything's great, and I love everything. She just flip-flops every few seconds, and I love, like, listening to the audiobook, too, because Rosamund Pike, she does the voices so well, and she does the most obnoxious Mrs. Bennett voice. And also, she does a really creepy Mr. Collins voice. It's, like, really breathy and slimy, and it's like, hello, I'm Mr. Collins. It makes you cringe. But, oh, my gosh, she's so... And I love her and Mr. Bennett, how they play off of each other.
Yeah.
Then I wonder, like, if it was in today, if they would get divorced or not. Because I feel like, they got on each other's nerves a bunch, but then also you could feel that they loved each other. But then, I don't know. That's what I think about a lot. Because there was, like, no divorce back then, basically. There was some, but...
I was trying to figure out, because there was a point in time where, like, he talked about how he married Mrs. Bennett and how, like, she wasn't what is he? Isn't he, like, a person of a higher stature?
Yeah,
He's a gentleman.
Yeah. But he's not like he's a gentleman. He's not like a lord or anything. Yeah. He did own property.
I would like to see that story of like how they came together, because he just kind of tolerates her.
That's a he hates like, everybody but Elizabeth and sometimes Jane. He's like, oh my gosh, I have the most annoying daughters all the time. And I'm like, he's saying it when they're in the room, like, at the same table. He's just like, you guys are obnoxious and dumb.
But I love him so much. He's one of my all-time favorite characters. Every time, like, I love him in the movie, but every time I read the book, I'm like, you are one of my favorite characters of all time. He's so funny. I was trying to think of something that happened, like, within the first chapter, and I was like, I love him.
Yeah.
But mostly, like, the whole part whenever Mr. Collins proposes and he's like, from this day forward, you're going to have to, like, choose between your parents because I'm not going to talk to you if you marry him.
Yeah.
And he's like, yes, so good.
I love it when he says, when Mrs. Bennett is like, you have no thought for my poor nose. And he's like, you're wrong. I have the constant. I have, like, the...
They've been my companion these many years.
Yeah. I love when he says that.
I think Mrs. Bennett would definitely be a Slytherin. Like, 1,000%. Because, like, just all the... Like, she's so crafty. Like, she comes up with all these little schemes. Like, sending Jane to get sick. I would never have thought about that. But, and then Lydia would be a... She'd be a Gryffindor or a Slytherin.
Lydia? I feel like she's, like, just a Hufflepuff.
A Hufflepuff?
I don't know. I don't think...
She's definitely not a Ravenclaw.
She's not a Ravenclaw.
Let's be real.
I think Jane's definitely a Hufflepuff.
Yeah.
Just so simple.
I think Lizzie is a Ravenclaw, though.
Huh.
Like a Ravenclaw Gryffindor, like a...
Gryffindor. But I think she's more of a Ravenclaw because she's like, she is brave, but she's more like thoughtful and like thinks about a lot of things. And, but she also does have that Gryffindor, like, I'm just going to go walk to their house. It's fine. Everything's fine.
She's very loyal. And she like, especially for that time, she like does as much as she can for being a woman of like a lower class than the other people she's with. So I don't know. I feel like she cares more about family than...
Well, I feel like she's more of a Gryffindor because she has such like a quick tongue. And I don't think Ravenclaws say such.
I don't know. She's definitely on the brink of those two. I don't know. And then,
why are we talking about?
Because it's important. Every single book I read, I basically just sort all the characters.
I think that Mr. Bennett would be a Slytherin, though, or a Ravenclaw.
I think he'd be a Ravenclaw because he just wants to be alone and read his books.
True.
Oh, someone had a question. Kelsey has a question. Have any of you seen the Pride and Prejudice miniseries with Colin Firth?
Yes.
I have, yeah.
I've watched bits and pieces. We were watching it on a choir tour bus, like, while we were traveling across the country. So, beyond that, no, I haven't watched it.
It's on Amazon Prime.
Yeah, when I first saw Amazon Prime, I was able to watch it, and it was just, I love it because it's so long, and you can just sit there and watch Pride and Prejudice for, like, 8 to 10 hours. I don't know how long it is, but
I think it's, like, 5, 6 hours?
Huh.
10? Okay. I watch it in one sitting.
It's
10 hours.
The only thing I don't like about the miniseries, there's like the one scene where he hands her like the first proposal, and they have like the fight, and he gives her the letter, and she's reading the letter as he's like writing it, and what Lizzie does, the actress who plays Lizzie, she's all like, and it's like all these overlays of him being frustrated and her being frustrated. It's so corny.
I think the thing is, it's just so wonderfully corny. Like, he comes, like, he swims in the
book. Yeah.
That never happens in the book, but it's just, like, they add that for, like, I don't know. It's just wonderfully, like, kind of over the top and like over dramatic in some ways. I don't know. And then I just love Colin Firth, even though he's like 50.
Can I take a brief sidestep, which is, have you guys seen the North and South miniseries, which is not Jane Austen at all, but it's like that time period? Well, I think it's a little later. It's really good. You should watch it. Okay.
Cool.
There you go.
Oh, so it's just like after that? Or it's like in the hundreds?
I think it's like in that era. It's about
I think it's more like Civil War.
Yeah. No, it's not Civil War. It's earlier than that.
Is it that one with the actor who's in The Hobbit? I can't think of his name.
What? Yes. Richard Armitage.
Yes.
That one?
I remember her having like she has like bell sleeves, so that's more of like Civil War time. So it's later in the 1800s.
Interesting. Wow. It's still good.
That's Everybody how you know. Wants. You know by the fashion.
It's really good, so just watch it. Okay.
Yeah, bye. You should watch it, though. It's really good.
I will. Is that on Netflix?
I watched it when it was on Netflix.
Okay.
I watched it illegally, so.
Cool. I think, I saw it somewhere, and I wanted to watch it, but then I didn't. Yeah.
There's another little scene. Like, I think it was like 2 or 3 episodes. It was like 20 years after Pride and Prejudice takes place. It's on Netflix. I don't remember what it's called. I watched it
Death
last
Comes year. Pemberley?
What?
Is it Death Comes to Pemberley?
Yes, it was so good.
Oh, I need to watch that still.
It's a book. Someone gave me the book, and I haven't read it yet. But, I don't know. I'm a little scared, because, like, I don't like messing with the classics too much, but I don't know. I kind of want to watch it. I probably will. Maybe that'll be one of the movie night choices. Possibly.
Yes.
What are your favorite quotes? I like insolent girl, as you can tell. But I don't know.
I like what I already said about Mr. Bennett saying that he was like that Elizabeth had to choose between him or her mother if she married Mr. Collins. Really anything Mr. Collins says about Catherine de Bourgh, because they're all just like the most ridiculous things in the entire world. It's like, well, Mr. Bourgh does this. And it's like, okay.
He says her name like once a sentence.
It's true.
Like Lady Catherine de Bourgh.
I have two favorite quotes, and they're only my favorite because they're from the movies. The one with Keira Knightley. It's when Miss Bingley goes, oh, did you see her hem? 6 inches deep in mud. It's positively medieval. I love that one. Or when Lizzie goes, Darcy asks, like, oh, how would you advise to create some love notions? I forget what he says. And she goes, dancing. But fooling one's partner is barely tolerable. And I love that.
Oh, that's a good one. I think.
I love the dance scene in that movie.
So good.
Yeah.
With the sexual tension. They're just like.
The stare.
Also, everyone else like is gone from the ballroom. It's just them. And they're like, oh, no, we don't like each other. Mm-mm. No, no. Oh,
is this at the Netherfield ball?
Yes.
I got this pillow from Etsy. It has a bunch of Jane Austen quotes on it.
Aww.
So I have to saw which one.
I also like in the book anytime that like, oh crap, what's her name? What's Bingley's sister's name?
Miss Bingley.
Anytime she like insults.
Caroline,
there you go. Anytime she insults, Lizzie and like Darcy just like sticks up for her in the book, and it's like super unnecessary, and she just gets really flustered because she's like trying to prove him wrong, and he's just like, it's the best.
Well, like when she's just trying to flirt with him and he's not having it, like she's like, you write so fast, how do you write so fast and so neatly? And then when he's like, the fine eyes in a pretty lady or whatever, and she's like looking at him like, look at my eyes. But you're so desperate, Caroline. Oh my goodness. What's your favorite part of the movie? Mine is when they're dancing together. Yes. I agree. What? Wait, guys, go to the Twitter. The ostentatious thing. Kelsey, she...
What?
Is that the lake that... Do you see it?
Oh my gosh, because London immortalized the lake scene.
Is that the actual lake scene?
I've seen that.
That's real?
Yeah.
What is this?
Have you seen that?
Where is this?
Why did I not see that when I was in London?
I think it was
just for a celebration.
Wait, do you see the boat? And then he's coming. Why is he so big?
Oh my gosh, he is giant! I thought.
Have you guys ever seen that? I've seen that on Tumblr so many times.
Maureen, we've obviously never seen it if we're reacting like this.
Oh my goodness! I just like
it's so funny because
where the shirt is. Oh my god!
I think it's not still there. I think it was for like a festival or something.
Why is it temporary? Why is it not there forever?
That's so funny.
Oh my goodness. That is... I wish I saw that so badly.
Am I behind?
What? Am I behind?
A little bit.
No.
I'm like really behind so. On my screen.
No. Ew.
Hello? Are you there? Hello?
It's me, Fiona.
What?
No!
What?
Am I coming through?
Yes.
Hello? Let's clap at the same time. See if we're 1, 2, 3, clap.
I was a little behind you.
Okay, this is never going to solve it, hopefully.
I'm, like, totally frozen.
No, you're not frozen on this.
You're not frozen on mine, either.
Oh.
Oh, it was in 2013 with Darcy. Ah, darn it. They should have kept that forever. It should have been a landmark for a time. Oh. It's giant. Oh, 12 feet tall.
Oh, my gosh. That's
so ridiculous. Where is it now? Can I buy it? Can I put it in a swimming pool nearby? Okay, what should we talk about now? Have any of you started Persuasion yet?
No. Sorry.
I have not either. When do we need to finish?
When do we need to finish by?
It's September's book of the month, so by the end of September.
Okay, I need it's to.
Shorter than this one is, though.
I'll probably read it after this week, because I'm reading The Kite Runner for Diversathon, and I also am in the middle of Empire Storms, and by the middle, I mean, like, page 50.
What's the middle? It's only 100 pages, of course. Natasha?
Now you're frozen.
Natasha, you are gone now.
Oh, no. You moved a little bit.
I can hear you.
I can hear you, too. Hello.
Okay, hello. Wait. I'm going to go on my iPad. Keep going. I'm going to go on my iPad, okay?
Okay.
We'll just keep filling the silence. Hello, people watching this live stream. How are you doing? I cannot hear you or anything. There's no Q&A because I didn't know how to set up the Q&A. So if you want to ask us questions or just talk to us about things or suggest topics you want us to talk about, go to Twitter and do hashtag ostentatious or just at Zoe Hurt, at me, or at Maureen, or at Natasha, so that we can see your tweets and we can answer them and have a fun time, you know? Right now.
Oh no.
We're going to talk about what?
My phone's on 13%. Hey, welcome back.
Hello, Natasha, welcome back. Now we have one of you and a frozen one of you. There are two Natasha.
No.
It's all good. Double the Natasha is great.
Okay.
As you can tell, people who are probably watching this after this has gone up, we had a lot of technical difficulties this time, so next live show, it's going to go a lot smoother. None of us have done live streams really before, so
well, now it's
fumbling for this first one, but we'll get better.
This newfangled thing.
I know, they changed something. Also, I haven't done it with other people before, so it's just a whole mess. But we can only go up from here. Okay.
It's true.
Yeah. So who was your favorite character? Except Mr. Bennett, Maureen. And Elizabeth, because that's just too easy. Or Mr. Darcy. None of the main people. Oh. Who was your favorite? You can't say like Elizabeth Bennett, because obviously.
Probably Colonel Fitzwilliam.
Oh, yeah.
I love him. He's great. But it's also, I feel like I'm partial because of Lizzie Bennet Diaries and Fitz being the best.
Fitzwilliams? Oh, I love how they... And then there's Bingley. They just did it. It was so funny. They got it right.
I don't know. I mean, there's, like, characters who I love who I would love to play, and then there's, like, characters that I love. Like, I would love to either be Mrs. Bennett or Caroline Bingley. I think they're...
You just like to be the dramatic,
people. Yes, I like to be the dramatic people.
They would be the most fun people to play. Like, even Mary, you just sulk around all the time, like, you don't love me, family.
Yeah, or I guess I would pick Kitty. Because she's, like, not as
Kitty.
Lydia.
Or Lydia, yeah. That'd be fun. We should just do it. Let's do... I know it's been done before, but let's do it again.
Yeah, BEA.
I really want to come to BEA this year. I'm really trying to come to the whole thing this year. That's my goal. I really want to.
It's in New York this year, right?
Yeah, that's the other reason that I would have to go to the whole thing or none at all.
You're so loud. Why are you so loud?
I don't know. I'm just talking into my mic. It's right here.
You can change your volume in the control.
I'm going to mute you more. I don't know.
I had to turn you guys down because you guys were too loud.
Oh. Sorry.
I'm just talking normally. Do you need me to talk quieter? Do I need to do some ASMR talking?
Yeah, I'll just turn some ASMR live show. How are you? Talk now, Maureen.
Hello? Is this normal? I'm talking normally, so.
Natasha to talk.
Hi, everyone. I love Mr. Darcy. I would like to marry him, please.
That's a simple request.
See,
I will grant it.
Now you are loud and Natasha's really quiet for me.
What? I turned her up. And I turned you down. Loud. This is not going to work. So we're going to rewatch this and it's going to be all over the place. I really want there to be a Sense and Sensibility, one of like the webisode type things. They need to do that because I feel. What?
I've never seen like Lizzie Bennet Diary.
What? Are you kidding?
What?
I know. Oh, and I'm like such a huge fan of Pride and Prejudice. They're worth watching, right?
What? They're so good. I've watched it through like 3 times. I'm approved too.
But Lizzie Bennet Diaries is a lot better, to be honest.
I don't think it's a lot better. I think they are like that. They're just different. They're so much.
It's 9 hours.
With the Emma. What? Yeah, it's 100 episodes. It's 100 episodes, and they're like 2 minutes, 4 minutes. Some of them are 7 minutes, but they vary. So it's like one day. It's possible to do it in one day, but you probably should bring it up over like a week, or else all you'll do is watch them. But they're so good. I'm so surprised you haven't. Okay, your homework for this next month before we do our next live show. I will not let you join unless you have
honestly, you really need to watch it, Natasha. You would love it.
It's so.
Can I just say how much I love Lizzie Bennet Diaries is what got me into Tumblr. It's what like really got me into like being more involved in the internet community, and that's like what pushed me to even further do BookTube. So thanks, Lizzie Bennet Diaries. Well, I watched it live, like. Starting like 10 episodes in, I watched it every week live, and I was like,
"Yeah, it was in 2013, right?"
Yes, to 2014, and I like really started doing YouTube like really, really, really in like January of 2014.
Because I remember I was still in high school, and people were talking about it in English class, and I was like, "What? Hello!" And I also had to do a paper on Pride and Prejudice at the same time, so it helped.
I don't remember how I found it. I have no idea.
Just stumbled on it.
It was so good though.
They have a Sense and Sensibility web series. What? Marianne and Eleanor Take Barton. Ooh. Thank you, Sarah. I did not know that.
But who did it?
It's not Pemberley Digital.
Yeah, it's not Pemberley Digital.
But I'm sure this one's good too.
Yeah. Another good web series. Nothing Much to Do is a fantastic web series if you want literary web series. That's an adaptation of the Shakespeare play, and it's really, really, really good.
Ooh. Yeah, there's a lot. There's an Anne of Green Gables one. I think there's a Peter Pan one, right?
Yes, we talked about that. It's kind of a Peter Pan one. It's more like, it's like very, very basic Peter Pan, but it has some magical realism in it. They're in their third season? I stopped watching after the first season. Maybe? I don't know. I stopped watching after the first season, so I haven't kept up with it.
I'm looking up the Marianne one right now. Oh, it's like people just decided to do it themselves. That's so cool, though.
It is really cool.
I just want to see it with, like, the budget of Pemberley Digital.
While we're on the subject of web series, I really want to watch Single by 30, but I also don't want to get YouTube Red, so.
No, YouTube Red. Are we allowed to talk about YouTube Red on YouTube? Will they, like, shut this down if we're bashing YouTube Red? But isn't there a trial for YouTube Red for like a month?
Well, maybe. We did try. Everyone got YouTube Red for a month.
We did? I had it?
Yeah, for like a month.
Oh, no.
Stuff was on. I have YouTube Red because I pay for Google Music, and so I pay for Google Music, I get YouTube Red and music.
Okay. Well, that makes more sense if you get it with other things, but
yeah,
I just do Spotify, so.
I never, like, watch anything. I think the one thing I watch on YouTube, okay, we're not talking about YouTube, we're talking about.
Oh, Pride and Prejudice. We're just chatting now.
That's why people need to ask questions.
Oh, yes. Ask questions, please.
Or else we'll just start talking about YouTube Red again.
We'll just start chatting about stuff.
There was a question, by Caitlin. Which character do you identify with? Have we already answered this?
Oh, no, I didn't see that one.
Oh, I just saw another one that I was like, I want to answer it. What character do I most identify with?
I want to say Elizabeth, but I know I'm not Elizabeth. I want to be like Elizabeth, but probably like...
I'm probably more like a Mary.
Probably like Mary. Just following people around. Being left behind. FOMO and all that.
No, you're not.
What?
I feel like, Zoe, you would definitely be a Jane, and Maureen, you would, Ooh, Jane.
So I am beautiful. That's all I
am. I'm trying to think who, wait, Maureen, who'd you identify with?
Mary.
So I feel like I'm a Mary.
You're not Mary.
Mary. I don't know.
Part about being like really like not about this life when they're like having balls, just like nah.
Very. I don't know who I am. I think I'm more Elizabeth. Maybe.
I think you are. You're just outspoken and, you know.
Yeah.
You're just. I get. There's no words for it. It's just the essence of you. I feel like
I'm more like if we're going like Jane Austen characters. I'm more like a.
What has happened to this?
What? I didn't hear anything.
S
what?
It's like primary to the zombies.
What just happened?
I didn't hear anything.
You just got possessed by something.
It was me. I didn't. I don't know what happened.
Oh my gosh. What were you saying?
What happened? Someone tell me.
Like your voice just went like demon.
Anyway.
What were you saying?
I was saying if we're talking just Jane Austen characters, I feel like I'm an Eleanor from Sense and Sensibility more than anything in Pride and Prejudice.
Are you? Yeah, you're pretty sensible. You're like... What?
Sensible?
Sensible.
Sensible.
Oh, he's made himself indispensable. Hamilton.
This is Pride and Prejudice.
I had to.
This is certain. 40 years before Pride and Prejudice.
Someone says, how did you get into Jane Austen? School. It was school. It was required reading, and then I liked it, which I was very surprised about it, because at first I was doing, like, all spark notes, and I was like, I'm just gonna skim through it, but then I got into the story.
It was probably my mom, but at the same time, I was really obsessed with Keira Knightley because of Pirates of the Caribbean, and I wanted more of her, so that's why I watched Pride and Prejudice. It was only rated PG, so I fell in love with that movie, and then when we got to read it freshman year, I was like, yay!
Yay!
I think my mom showed me Sense and Sensibility, like, way before I ever saw Pride and Prejudice.
I feel like that one's harder to understand when you're younger because it's, like, primogeniture and stuff, which is like all of the family fortune goes to like the first male heir, which I didn't understand when I was younger, but then once I studied it, like I understand the story now. But that's why I think Pride and Prejudice is a lot easier to start with, because you don't really need to know any backstory about the time, except like the generic, like women don't have all the rights as men do, like they have to get married and stuff like that, but that's pretty simple. But what about you?
I think that the first time I really, like, got into anything Jane Austen was watching the 2005 movie, because everyone was obsessed with it. Because that was my freshman year of high school, I think, when that came out. So everyone was like, oh my God, Pride and Prejudice. But I didn't actually like read one of the books until, because I didn't have to read them for school. I didn't read Pride and Prejudice until Lizzie Bennet Diaries. And then like once that finished, I read the book and I could like relate all the things that happened in the show with the book. So I was like, oh yeah.
Yeah, it's a really faithful adaptation. Like they didn't really, except they had to modernize it a bit. Like she's a grad student and stuff with Lydia. And stuff, and they kind of updated it.
Catherine de Bourgh, like,
lady
at the end.
Yeah. But then, because there's only, like, a few people who are actually on screen, they had to...
Yeah.
You'll see when you watch it, Natasha. But...
Hey.
It's so good.
Oh, someone says, which character do you dislike the most?
Mr. Collins?
Or
Wickham.
Really? Wickham!
Wickham.
Wickham. He has
actually, you know what? I don't like Lady Catherine de Bourgh either. So
I don't like Mrs. Bennet.
Yeah, I think she's just like she's entertaining enough that I don't dislike her that much. She's just so theatrical that I don't know.
She's so ditzy and like says the wrong things, and she's the one who ruined it all for both girls at the beginning.
Yeah. She's like, they're gonna get married in like a month. They don't even know.
I wanna answer the one about what's your favorite Mr. Collins moment, because I know mine.
Wait, what's yours?
The one about the potatoes where he's talking like really fancily about the potatoes and Lizzie's like, do you pre-prepare your speeches or something like that?
Oh, yeah.
Like, I mean, sometime. He basically admits it, but...
It's like, yes, I do think about what I'm going... Like, I like think about situations I'm going to be in, and like, he's just oblivious.
My favorite moment is when Lizzie is at their house and Miss Catherine de Bourgh calls on them, and he's like, don't matter about what you're wearing, just put on what the best you have, even if they're plain or something like that. Where he's like basically like insults her wardrobe.
Well, yeah. And then he like goes back and forth between everybody's rooms, like checking on them and making sure that they're wearing their nicest thing, and he like is like going back and forth like, are you wearing it? Like, are you fine?
I'm trying to think of one right now, but I feel like I'm getting mixed up with Lizzie Bennet Diaries. Oh my goodness.
What is it?
The one that I remember from the Lizzie Bennet Diaries is that like he gives, no, I'm not going to say it because I don't want to spoil.
I'm just like.
What?
I just love Maxwell Glick plays Mr. Collins in the Lizzie Bennet Diaries, and he's so lovable that I'm like, it's hard.
No, he's not like as obnoxious as, well, he is obnoxious, but he's not as dislikable. He's just like a happy puppy who doesn't know any better. But I'm trying to think.
The actor who plays Mr. Collins in Pride and Prejudice 2005 movie is also in Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yeah,
he is. He's another like obnoxious guy.
Yeah, he's like an Englishman, right?
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
He's like the captain of one of the ships.
Yeah. That's a good franchise. Are they making another one? Another Pirates of the Caribbean?
Well, they have. I think they had. I don't know what they were doing with the fifth one that they were doing, because they were going to make, like, the three more. What?
Orlando Bloom's in it.
The fifth one?
Yeah.
Really? That's exciting. I want to know what his character is up to.
So is his son.
Yay!
Someone says, Shannon says, what do you think about Lady Catherine pushing Darcy and Lizzie together when she was trying to do the exact opposite? I think it was so funny. It just blew up in her face.
Wait, what was the question?
What do you think about Lady Catherine pushing Darcy and Lizzie together when she was trying to do the exact opposite? When she was like, are you like engaged to my nephew and whatever? Oh, everyone's just like so dumb at times, but that's how life works. Ooh, what?
There's a question. I like this. It's from Charlie, but spelled
C-H-A. Oh, yes.
If Jane Austen had co-written a novel with another female author, who should it have been?
At the same time?
Like living at the same time as her? I think that one of the Brontes. What? Or just anyone?
Like, anybody?
Well.
No.
I was like, at the same time as her was the Bronte sisters, and we all, I don't know if you guys know that they like all didn't really like each other, so... Yeah, that wouldn't have been a good co-writing
experience. I didn't know that. Oh, my goodness.
I feel he and Diana Gabaldon should write something together.
That would work very well. I feel like their writing styles are kind of similar-ish for it being, like, a classic versus a modern novel. And they could... It would be basically... Because it's basically like a Jane Austen novel, but with time travel.
That's and sex.
And what?
Sex.
I mean, yeah, that's the modern part. I mean, we could all, I think about Jane Austen with that. Someone says, okay, would Mr. Collins and Mary be a good couple? Okay, when I read it the first time, I was like, they deserve each other. They're both like so annoying and Mary likes to read boring stuff and stuff like that, but I don't think anybody deserves Collins, but I think that I just feel so bad that she was overlooked. They're like, oh, I can't have Jane and I can't have Elizabeth, so whatever, there's no one else left in this family, I'm gonna go somewhere else. But I think I think that it worked best that it was Charlotte, because she needed a husband, because she was in such a bad situation. Mm-hmm. But I think if Charlotte wasn't in the picture, if she was already married, then I think that would have been a good couple, because Mary doesn't really talk to anybody. But then,
And it says at the end of the book that, well, we don't know, like, much further in the future, but that she didn't get married, that, like, she stayed at home, so.
Yeah, I could see her being an old maid. Because she, I don't know. Did she even want a husband? I feel like she didn't talk to anybody.
Probably not.
But I am sure Mrs. Bennet would push her into having one. Or maybe she would ease up after most of her daughters were married.
Yeah.
Time I think that I wanted to punch Mrs. Bennet the most, which is the whole book, but whenever at the end when she was talking about, like, her son-in-laws and, like, she ranked them and she was like, I think Wickham's still my favorite. And I was like, you don't even know!
Oh, that's one thing that I think the Colin Firth version did better, like, illustrating, is Wickham and how terrible he is.
Yeah. Because
they showed, like, the behind the scenes, or they showed him with, Georgiana and what happened.
Yeah.
And it's just in the book and in the 2005 version, you kind of know, but
yeah,
it doesn't show it.
Yeah, there's like nothing of Wickham in the 2005 movie.
Does it even, it mentions briefly, like in the letter, he reads the letter aloud. He's like, oh, he did something to my sister. But that's the one part that I really like, the Colin Firth version. But then the rest of it, I like the 2005 version more.
Yeah, it's so pretty.
Mm-hmm. And the music.
That's my favorite score.
Dun, 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 dun.
I know. I want that to be played in the wedding. That would be so pretty. Mm.
More questions?
Of all time.
What?
That's my favorite movie of all time.
Wow.
Yeah. I think mine too. I could watch it over and over again.
The thing is, like, I watched it when I was 11. I watched it now and I love it. I know in the future I will love it. So
Yeah, I watched it when I was young too, and I didn't even understand what was happening, but I'm like, I like this movie.
There's a
you guys are, and you're like, I watched it when I was 11, and I was like, I was in high school when it came out.
It's not that much different.
I know, but it feels different. It's like 3 years.
3 long years.
When I went to Forks last week, and like I was talking to some of the young girls who were at the high school. I was 14 when I first read Twilight, and they're like, "Oh yeah, I was 9." I'm like,
"Shut up!"
My parents would not let me read Twilight when I was 9. There's no way.
Bless you. My dad sneezed, but no response. No, thank you. How rude. He just took it and left. No, I was 13 when I read Twilight. 12, 13? One of those. But I didn't read Breaking Dawn when I was 9. I mean, I was 14, 15, so I wasn't that much older. But imagine reading that.
I was a sophomore in high school, and I started because I started when New Moon came out. And so I read those two. And then I read Eclipse as soon as it came out. And then I remember when Breaking Dawn came out because I was on a trip. Because it came out in the summer and I was on a trip. And I made my mom buy it and bring it in the car for when I got off the trip so I could start reading it in the car. And that was my senior year, I think, of high school. I don't remember when it came. When did it come out? Does anybody know years?
Yeah, it was 2008.
Yeah, it would have been the summer before my senior year of high school.
Such a simple time. August 4th.
Yep, I was on a choir tour.
You know it.
It's my church. Well, I was I got back. I think it came out Tuesday or whatever, or whatever day that was. And I got back 2 days later, and I was like, Mom, you have to buy it. You have to bring in the car with you.
I was at church camp too when it came out.
Oh, I was at home, so I just read it. I was a little creature. someone said, Lily said, what modern books do you think both Jane Austen and Lizzie Bennet would read?
Ooh,
Outlander.
I think that too, but I think
if they were modern day time, I feel like they would read
50 Shades.
If it was they were not just placed in modern time, but they were modern people. You know what I'm saying? I feel like they would like YA contemporary. I feel like they would like Morgan Matson. I think Jane Austen would like Morgan Matson because it's love story, but with depth in it, which is her books are love story, but with depth. So,
yeah.
I feel like Lizzie would like books with fighting in it as well. I don't know why. Yeah. I feel like she would like more action as well.
Yeah, she would like Throne of Glass, I think, and stuff
like
that.
But then Jane would be all over Morgan Matson.
But
yeah. What about Clockwork, the Mortal Instruments?
Oh yeah, because that's good because it has a contemporary-ish feel. Well, not contemporary, but realistic feel to it.
Yeah.
I miss that series. I want to read that again, but with fresh eyes. Again for the first time. It's so frustrating.
It twists. So good.
Another question. If you were alive at the time of Pride and Prejudice, what would be your favorite and least favorite parts of living back then? No plumbing.
Yeah.
Would be my least favorite part. And there's no Wi-Fi, too. I feel like I get bored so
quickly. Well, if you were born in that time, you wouldn't even know what Wi-Fi was.
But if I was me now, the question makes it seem like you know today's modern convenience.
I would like wearing dresses. Not all the time, but I think for balls. I would like getting dressed up for balls and going to balls and having a dance card. So it's you have to dance with people.
Courtship process I really like.
Yeah.
Because it's awkward for everybody, so.
I would be all about courtship life. Bring me out. Let me show the town. I would be
I think hygiene is a big part that I would not brushing your teeth too. You use twigs and salt. And I like clean teeth.
Wig and salt.
Yeah, no, you use like birch branches, I think. Birch twigs. It's a mess. But then I think, yeah, definitely like I want to go to a ball so badly.
You could go, what's it called? Starts with a C. C dancing. It's line dancing, but it's like Pride and Prejudice style line dancing. Like what? They have like some more like country style dances, but they have ones that are like that slow. And they're because when I say line dancing, I know the first thing most people think of is like country line dancing. It's like, no, this is like where you have like two people on each side and you guys do dances together. I think it's contra, C-A-N. Okay. My aunt does it in Nashville all the time, so that's how I know. Contra dancing. Yeah. Contra, C-O. Contra dance.
Okay.
Is a folk, well, I guess it's like folk dance, but it's like long lines of people. It has mixed origins from English country dance, Scottish, French dance styles from the 17th century, with strong African inference from the Appalachia.
I am standing up for a class.
But just so you guys know, that's a thing that you can do.
Oh, Shannon has a good question. Why do you think Wickham ran off with Lydia when he knew her family didn't have much money?
I've always wondered about this.
I think he knew that Darcy would pay him off because he knew that Elizabeth... No. What?
I'm just saying no. Go ahead. Sorry, keep talking. I'm just going to give my opinion. I just said no, I don't think so. I think he was in it for a good time and Lydia pushed it farther because I think he was probably trying to get rid of her. And she was like, no, let's keep going. And like, that's how I think he was like, I'm going to have a fun time with this girl and just kind of like leave her out to dry. He was trying to like shake her off, but it didn't happen. And she was like, no, like especially whenever he was like, we're not going to get married and not go to Gretna Green. I think he thought at that point she was probably like, he thought she would be like, no, we're not like, oh no, like I need to leave. But she was like, no, it's fine.
Like, where are you going, baby? We're getting married now, aren't we?
I think he was trying to shake her off. And so she was like, no, we're going to stay together.
I think I just give him too much credit. Like, I'm like, the whole time he knew. But
yeah, no, I don't think
he's not that smart.
I don't think he thought that Darcy would pay him off because he didn't really know about Darcy and Elizabeth. He thought that they hated each other.
Because he like set the seeds of her hating him.
In the book there's like a little thing from Lydia that says like before she leaves that she's planning to like run off with Wickham. So were they like noodling before she went to Brighton or did they?
I don't think so. I think in Brighton they like, well, I mean they met before, but I think in Brighton was where it like solidified itself.
Well, she knew there were going to be officers there. Did she know that Wickham was going to be there?
Well, he was part of that regiment.
Yeah. I don't know. Huh. But now that you say it, I definitely think he just wanted to be a fling. But then, no to flings.
You know how intense Lydia was going to be.
Yeah. He underestimated her power. Oh, where would you want to live in the Pride and Prejudice universe? Pemberley, Netherfield, London, Longbourn, Meryton. London, obviously, but then...
I think London or Pemberley are my two tops, because Pemberley's got them grounds, but London has all the, like, socialite stuff.
Yeah. But London's also stinky.
True.
I'm thinking, like, modern.
I say, like, house in London, house at Pemberley, go back
and forth. Just be Gigi Darcy. Just have both. Be rich.
Gigi Darcy. Go in Lizzie Bennet Diaries.
I don't care about Georgiana. I always thought her name was Georgina the entire time. And then I heard, like, I watched the movie again. They're like, Georgiana. Where did that come from? So that's why I just love with Gigi. It's straightforward. I went to the place where they based, where she based Pemberley off of, and that's also where they filmed the 2005 version, and it's so nice, it's so big, there's a fountain and ground, so I think in today, I would want to live in London, but then, like, back then, you definitely want, like, because it's also, like, more glamorous, you know?
Yeah.
And you have all these servants. You don't have to move.
O-R-O-U-S.
But. What part were you most surprised by in the book or movie?
I don't remember my surprise of anything because I feel like I've watched it forever.
Yeah, it's so ingrained in me.
I think the first surprise I remember is when Lizzie finds out about how Darcy's the one that took Bingley away the first time.
Oh, yeah.
Like, she, like, in the movie, she comes out, like, in church, and, like, that whole part where she's, like, looking at him, and he looks at her, she's like, and then they run off to that place, and he, like, proposes to her. I'm like, no!
With the rain! The dramatic rain! I love the rain. I also, the part that, like, most, like, shocked me, I guess, it didn't really surprise me, but it was, I remember reading it, and I just burst out in laughter, was when Lady Catherine de Bourgh came in the middle of the night, and she was like, hello. Why? I'm like, why did you come all the way there just to yell at her?
Well, she comes in the middle of the morning in the book. But
I'm mixing it up with the movie now, but yeah, I'm like, she came all the way there just to, yeah, like, she didn't even try to get the facts before she came.
Yeah. Did you see...
It's a matter of life and death, Zoe.
Okay. All right.
Did you see that the movie Pride, Prejudice, and Zombies?
I haven't seen it.
I haven't seen it either. I kind of want to watch it for Matt Smith.
He's in it?
Yeah.
I forget who he plays.
I think he plays Mr. Collins.
Yeah. But in the... my things that movie. Okay. In the Lena Headey plays Catherine de Bourgh. She's Cersei Lannister in Game of Thrones. And it's so funny. She's so badass.
Wait, what?
Really? Oh, she was in okay. She played Lady Catherine de Bourgh?
Yeah. Why?
Why? She's so young.
Wait, in Pride and Prejudice. Like wait, when did she play her?
Lady Catherine de Bourgh.
Pride, Prejudice, and Zombies.
Oh, and Zombies. I was like, not in the 2005 version. That lady's old.
That's Dame. She's a dame.
Judy. Is that Judy Dench?
Judy Dench.
Okay, I'm right. Good.
I want to watch Pride and Prejudice and Zombies. I'm not, like, expecting much out of it, but I kind of want to watch it because it looks, like, well-made. So yeah. That's why I want to watch it.
It's like a watch one time thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a watch one time thing.
Mm-hmm. Watch one time on Redbox, not in theaters.
Yeah.
I don't like the guy who plays Darcy. He's like okay.
Who plays
It's Cinderella. What's her face?
Oh yeah, that's another reason I want to watch it
because with the eyebrows.
Yes.
Nah. Lily James, is that her?
Oh yeah, Darcy just—he's not Darcy. He's just like a lad, a fun guy.
Yeah,
fun guy.
Lily
Collins. I was gonna say that.
He's not that bad, but I feel like Mr. Bingley is cuter than Mr. Darcy.
Oh. I forgot to say, were we talking about favorite scenes a while ago? Because I forgot to say another one of
them. Why does Lady Catherine have an eye patch?
She's like a zombie warrior. Maureen, go ahead.
Favorite scene in the 2005 movie. There are so many. But my really, like, favorite scene is whenever they go into the house and, like, it's at the end, Bingley and Darcy, and it's, like, really awkward, and they leave, and then, like, Bingley's outside, like, practicing, and Darcy's, like, encouraging him, which is not something that happens in the book, obviously.
But it's the best, like, addition to it.
It's so fun. It's so
cool. You can do this.
I'm just like, oh. Oh, that was another thing. I'm just, like, throwing it back to the book where things, like, it feels like they progress more naturally, because like in the movie after his proposal, you're like, where the crap did that come from?
Yeah,
like
it's they like, person, like
five times, but then in the book, it's like weeks and weeks and weeks of hanging out and him like coming by himself and hanging out with them. So it's like more obvious what's about to happen. But yeah. In the movie, it's just kind of like
he just shows up and then he walks out and then it comes back. We should probably do like one more question because it's already been like an hour, right?
Yeah.
Went by so quickly. So everybody, which one of you can do the best British accent?
Oh,
not me.
I don't really want to try that.
Hello.
No, I'm not gonna try it.
Any line, I will do one.
She wins. She did the best. It's Natasha.
I didn't even do it. No, my favorite line to say in a British accent is the dancing, but if only his partner's barely tolerable.
Hey.
Good job.
Thank you.
Mr. Darcy or Mr. Bingley?
I like Bingley, TB.
I think for myself, I would want, well, Bingley's kind of like a little.
Well, I would want like a mix. I wouldn't want a Bingley that's like as much of a pushover as the Bingley in the book is like, oh yeah, I believe you because you're my friend. Like, but all the other aspects of him, like his niceness and like preciousness, that part, yes.
Yeah. Like, I like nice people, but also Mr. Darcy gets nicer. But I feel like I am so judgmental, though, that I wouldn't get over the original, like, reaction. Like, I don't think I would grow to love the person. The whole time I'd just be like, no, goodbye. And then I would, But he gets better. I don't know. I like George Knightley from Emma.
Oh, yeah. I love him so much.
He's my favorite of the Austen men.
Hmm.
But he is kind of, but I mean, like, a younger knight.
I like Mr. Darcy. I like his passion.
But you like the strapping lads, like, the manly men. I like the nice.
Nope.
I like passion, but just, like, a little.
I like nice guys too, Zoe, I'm in that boat with you. I just really like nice guys.
I like reading about Mr. Darcy, but for myself, I wouldn't want a Mr. Darcy. I would want the mixture. Good. Oh, Lily said that scene where they're practicing was all improvised, which makes it even better.
That's
so sweet. Oh my goodness. Oh, and apparently, Rosamund Pike and Bingley actually did date for a while.
Aww.
He's gay.
Oh.
So they're not together anymore. I think he's married now.
Aww.
It's a precious little lad. Okay, one more question. And then it will be the end. So if you have any questions, tweet it at us right now. Right now.
But we'll only answer one, so make your question.
Make it count, people.
How many people are watching this?
70! Hello, 70 people. How are you doing? Has your day been swell?
Hello, everyone. How are you doing? I hope that you are doing so
very well.
Who was it? Oh, who was it? I was messaging someone. Oh, I was... Was it Liz? I was, like, messaging someone, and I started with, like, hi, how are you? And then I, like, just went into my intro, and I, like, was, like, I just realized that was me doing my intro, and I'm really sorry.
Do you have an intro, Natasha?
No. I just say, like, on my vlogs, I always say, hello, everyone, and I make everyone else say, hello, everyone, like, echoing.
But for, like, your videos, yeah. I kind of wish that I didn't start doing, like, because now every time I don't do, like, hey, YouTube, it's, like, every time I do that, people are commenting, like, I'm having an existential crisis. Where was it?
Yeah, I think that's why I didn't do it. Sometimes do like a cold opener, like just some like funny line, and then like go into the video.
Ow, I just stubbed my toe.
Are we still waiting for a question?
Oh, yes, question. I forgot about that. I'm getting distracted. Okay, there is no more questions. You failed us.
Closing thoughts. The book is great.
The book is A++. It's a classic for a reason.
Yeah.
It's really great.
And I'm really excited to read the rest of the Jane Austen novels now.
Same.
I feel like this is something good for me, but I haven't like pushed myself to read all of them before, and it's really fun to talk about it, like especially classic love stories. I love them.
Mm-hmm.
So, thanks, Zoe.
No problem. I'm excited too because I haven't read all of them, but I'm excited to. Our next live show should be closer to the date that we all finish it, because that's why this is. I'm not really sure because I'm getting it mixed up with everything that I've watched since then. So next time, I think the next live show is going to be at the beginning of October, probably like October, whenever the first weekend is or whatever.
Or not. Or maybe you could do like a few days after that or before.
Or before it, so like next weekend.
The first weekend of October, just kidding. I'm good. I'm solid there.
Okay, we'll figure it out.
But I'm in Florida, remember? Oh. Remember.
You can just come on, sit next to me.
I'm going to be in Universal and Disney World for 2 days, so.
Yeah. But I think we're going to have a movie night this weekend.
Ooh.
I think it's going to be Bridget Jones' Diary.
Dang it! I've never seen Bridget Jones' Diary, but I can't this weekend.
Oh, yeah, you're in Connecticut, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, sucks to suck. No. but because it's based loosely on Pride and Prejudice, so that's how I justified watching it this weekend. So this Saturday, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Bridget Jones' Diary. We'll watch it together. And September's Book of the Month is Persuasion by Jane Austen, obviously. So if you haven't started yet, like none of us have started yet, you should probably start. And we should too. And I'll
first page.
You're on the first page?
Yep.
You're ahead of me. So yes, thank you so much for joining us here today. Next time, I promise we're going to start our live show at the time we say, because now we know how this live show thing works, so we're not going to be an hour and a half late to it again. We've learned from this experience. So
that's great. Good night.
Do you guys want to say something before we leave?
I'm excited to read Persuasion because it's one of my friend's favorites of all time, and I was like, oh. Okay.
That's such a random favorite.
She loves it so much, and she was like, you have to read it, and that was 2 years ago, and I still haven't read it, so.
Better late than ever.
Is there a Persuasion movie?
Yeah.
Actual movie?
It's TV movie.
Okay. Well, I'm excited to read Persuasion. I've only read Pride and Prejudice, so let's go.
Let's go. Okay. Love you all. See you soon with a new video. Hopefully we'll see how that goes. And I will talk to you all on Twitter and all of that. I love you. Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.